The stoush over just how clean and green New Zealand really is shows no sign of going away. Massey University scientist Mike Joy's been backed up by his scientific colleagues after saying our international image is as fantastical as dragons and wizards, something which hasn't impressed climate change minister Tim Grosser.
We've got to maintain progress, but I think people have also got to realise that we have to earn a living. And this is actually deeply unhelpful when we're trying to promote New Zealand.
Mike Joy says he would be happy if we were even 20% pure, and he joins us now from Palmerston North. Good morning to you, Mike. Tell me, what was your, what were you trying to do in making these statements? Was it designed to call time on this marketing campaign, or just draw everyone's attention to the fact we're falling short?
Well, I didn't know anything about the marketing campaign. I was contacted by a Kiwi journalist who worked for who told me he worked for International Herald Tribune, which I found out later owns the New York Times. But you know, I don't resolve from anything I said. He asked me the state of the environment, especially fresh water in New Zealand, and I gave him the facts. From what Mr. Grosser says, I can't figure out whether he wants me to lie about, you know, the facts, or is it that he just has no idea of the state of the environment in New Zealand? I can't figure out which of those is the case.
Some have criticised your comments as being something of an exaggeration. Are they the facts when you say we're 18th worst in the world? I mean, this particular measure is our measures on improving environmental efforts, is it not?
That's one of the figures that was quoted. I mean, it's very hard to compare, you know, international comparisons. But if you look at it, for example, we have more threatened species in this country than any other country in the world, proportionally. We have 68% of our freshwater fish species are threatened. That's a really strong sign that our freshwaters are in big trouble in this country. 18 to 30,000 people a year contract waterborne diseases. I mean, the list goes on. The facts are undeniable that we are not clean and green in our lowland areas.
So do you expect, with a statement like 100% pure, that we should be 100% or as close to it? Or do you accept that marketing is marketing and that it isn't necessarily a representation of fact?
Oh, totally. You know, I have no problem with 100% pure. I don't have any truck with you know, the tourism industry. They can say what they like. I don't expect things to be 100% pure. We are a country that has to be, we're primary producers. All I ask is that we stop declining. I mean, we've got shocking levels of pollution already. 96% of our lowland rivers you can't swim in or you'll get sick. I just want to stop it from getting worse. And I don't think the politicians that are you know, talking around this, or the people who have problems with what I'm saying, have any idea of just how bad things are and the fact that we're not getting better, we're getting worse.
Was it necessary, though, to do it in an international forum? Why not air these concerns at home with the people that have the power to do something about it?
Well, I've been airing these concerns for at least 10 years now. I've been campaigning to try and save the Manawatu River and then moving on, trying to protect freshwaters in New Zealand. I didn't go to an international paper. They came to me. I can't lie. It's my job as a researcher to bring these facts out. My belief is the only way we'll change is if everybody is aware that we have a problem. If an industry is quite happy for people, the industries that are involved in polluting our rivers are quite happy for people to think things are clean and green. The trouble with these campaigns is that you con the New Zealanders as well as the overseas people.
What then do you make of the backlash to your comments?
Well, I've had a huge amount of support. You know, I think looking at my emails, it's at least 50 support to one negative.
Are they primarily from the scientific community or elsewhere?
They're from all over the show, mostly from people I've never heard of, but certainly the scientific community is coming in behind me, because as a scientist, I'm just doing my job, and unless people want me to lie, then I have to tell the truth. That's what scientists do.
But I guess you've also had much harsher criticism, saying you're an economic traitor, that you are prone to exaggeration. What do you make of comments like that?
Well, I haven't heard the prone to exaggeration one, but I mean, how can I be the traitor? I'm not the traitor. I'm the whistleblower. I'm the messenger. It's not me that's polluted the rivers. Well, no more than any other New Zealander's polluted the rivers. It's industry, and it's particularly galling that at this moment, when we have huge freshwater issues in this country, and this government wants more intensive dairy farming, which is just going to make things worse.
Do you regret the timing of it at all? Obviously this week with the premiere of The Hobbit, there's a lot of attention on New Zealand anyway.
I spoke to the reporter at least 2 months ago. I don't think that he knew, well, he never mentioned this campaign. I don't know how long this campaign's been made public. I guess it was in secret up until very recently. So he was doing a story on New Zealand. I don't know for sure whether it was planned to be timed with this, or if this just came along about the time that he had the story ready and it was a good opportunity to do it.
Well, your comments have certainly provoked some interesting debate. Thank you very much, Mike Joy,
Thank
an
you.
Environmental scientist at Massey University.